NDDS, Novel Drug Delivery System. Novel Drug Delivery System refers to the approaches, formulation, technologies and systems for transporting a pharmaceutical compound in the body as needed to safely achieve its desired therapeutic effect. This is the definition of Novel Drug Delivery System. Hello friends, I am Rahul. I must welcome you in our YouTube channel Target GPA, the steer of success. Friends, today in this video, we will discuss important MCQs from this subject, Novel Drug Delivery System, for our GPA examination. So let's see this important question. So, the first question of novel drug delivery system, which is a spherical solid lipid particle prepared from physiological lipid dispersed in water or in aqueous surfactant solution, that is called solid lipid nanoparticle, liposomes, neosome and nanoparticle. So the correct answer is a spherical solid lipid particle prepared from physiological lipid dispersed in water or in aqueous surfactant solution is called solid lipid nanoparticles. Let's see question number 2. A prominent structure for ocular absorption of drugs. Options are conjunctiva, choroid, scleria or cornea. So the correct answer for this question is D. Cornea is a prominent structure for ocular absorption of drug. The polymer used in lacrimate, options are hydroxyethylcellulose, hydroxymethylcellulose, methylcellulose and hydroxypropylcellulose. So the correct answer is the propyl used in lacrimate is hydroxypropylcellulose. Okay. Question number 4. An ocular device that has to the shape of flake. Options are Ocucite, Lacrimate, NODS or SODI. So the ocular device that has the shape of a flake like it is NODS. Question number 5. Which of the following does not constitute an appendageal root? Here options are sweat glands, hair follicle, sebaceous gland and stratum corneum. So the correct answer is stratum corneum does not constitute an appendageal root. Question number 6. Transderm scope is used in the treatment of. Here options are hypertension, angina, motion sickness or antidote for smoking. So the correct answer is for question number 6. Transderm scope is used in the treatment of motion sickness. Okay. Question number 7. The size of particle in a parenteral suspension should be. So the correct answer, the particle size in a parenteral suspension should be less than 10 micrometer. The anterior part of the nasal cavity opening towards their face. Options are nasopharynx, nasal septum, nasal vestibule or nasal turbinate. So the correct answer is the anterior part of the nasal cavity opening toward the face, which is nasal vestibule. Okay. Monolithic devices have drug with a large therapeutic indexes, have rapid drug permeation, only hydrophilic polymer are used and release is through a polymer membrane. So the monolithic devices have a drug with the large therapeutic index. Okay. Question number 10. Drug release from osmotic drug delivery system depends on osmotic pressure, ionic strength, osmotic pressure and ionic strength, osmotic pressure and environment in GIT. So the correct answer is drug release from osmotic drug delivery systems depends on osmotic pressure. Okay. One method to prepare nanoparticle is, here options are pain coating, filtration, solubilization and precipitation. So the correct answer is one method to prepare nanoparticle, which is precipitation. Okay. excipient to increase density of GIDDS is zinc oxide, talc, sodium bicarbonate and calcium carbonate. So the correct answer for question number 12, zinc oxide is the excipient to increase density of GIDDS. Okay, blank is dispersed matrix system. Here options are nanospheres, nanoparticles and nanocapsules or nanopolymers. So the correct answer is nanospheres is a dispersed matrix system. Okay, let's see question number 14, which is chitosan is a mucoadhesive polymer. Here options are cationic, anionic, synthetic or non-synthetic. So the correct answer is chitosan is a cationic mucoadhesive polymer. Okay, let's see question number 15, which of the following is natural polymer used in nanoparticles. So the natural polymer used in nanoparticles, which is alginate. Okay, next question number 16, a microcapsule has drug dispersed in matrix, drug core surrounded by distinct wall and drug absorbed on the surface and drug distributed in polymeric matrix. So the correct answer for a microcapsule is as drug core surrounded by distinct wall. Okay, question number 17, a polymeric implant that is biodegradable is prepared from silicone, prepared from polyurethane, prepared from polylactic acid and prepared from polyacrylate. So a polymeric implant that is biodegradable, which is prepared from polylactic acid. Okay, question number 18, paracellular route for nasal drug delivery system is slow and passive lipoidal pathway, slow and passive aqueous pathway, fast and active aqueous pathway or fast and active lipoidal pathway. So the correct answer for paracellular route for nasal drug delivery system is it is slow and passive aqueous pathway. Okay, question number 19, sodium thiocolate used as a penetration enhancer is a surfactant, fatty acid with surfactant property, vile salt with surfactant property and vile salt but no surfactant property. So here the correct answer is sodium thiocolate used as a penetration enhancer is vile salt with surfactant property. Okay, question number 20, pH of nasal formulation in the physiological range. Option are keep the range in ionized state, alter physiological ciliary movement and increase mucosal irritation, or keep the drug in ionized state and sustained physiological ciliary movement. So the correct answer for question number 20, which is the pH of nasal formulation in the physiological range, keep the drug in unionized state and sustain physiological ciliary movement. Okay, so now let's talk about question number 21, which is mucociliary clearance is up. So the correct answer for mucociliary clearance is it is a barrier to nasal absorption but also protective in function. Okay, reservoir systems do not depend on area, have a rate controlling membrane, follow any order of kinetics or highly porous. So the correct statement for reservoir system, which is they have the rate controlling membrane. Okay, question number 23, factors affecting lymphatic uptake include larger aqueous base, greater hydrophilicity of nanoparticles, low concentration of surfactant and longer chain length of lipid. So the correct answer, factors affecting lymphatic reuptake include longer chain length of lipid. Okay, question number 24, steel liposomes have short half-life, are taken up by macrophages, have very large size, are sterically stabilized. So the correct answer for steel liposomes is are sterically stabilized. Okay, So let's see question number 25. An example of polymer incorporated into dendrimers is, her options are propylene glycol, polyethylenamine, polyurethane or strinco polymers. So here the correct answer for question number 21, which is polyethylenamine is the example of polymer incorporated into dendrimers. Okay, let's see question number 26. Modified balance method is used to evaluate particle size, adhesive strength, okay, drug release or swelling. So the modified balance method is used to evaluate adhesive strength. Question number 27. Udrajet AL100 is a type of cellulose polymer. Vinyl copolymers, methacetic acidocopolymer, methacrylic adicopolymer. So the correct answer for Udrajet AL100 is, it is methacrylic acidocopolymer. Question number 28. A primary irritation index of less than 2 for a transdermal patch indicates that patch is non-irritant, slightly irritant, moderately irritant or severely irritant. So the correct answer is for question number 28, a primary irritation index of less than 2 for a transdermal patch indicate that patches are slightly irritant. Okay, question number 29. Ideal glass transition temperature for a pressure sensitive adhesive used in transdermal system should be -20°C to -40°C, -2°C to -4°C, 20° to 40°C, 2° to 4°C. So the correct answer is, ideal glass transition temperature for pressure sensitive adhesive used in transdermal system should be -20°C to -40°C. Okay, question number 13. OQCite is an example of feedback regulation system, activation modulated system, bioresponsive system and membrane permeation system. So the correct answer is, OQCite is an example of membrane permeation system. Okay, let's see question number 31. Is an advanced method of determining size of nanoparticles. Here options are atomic force microscopy, ultrasound scattering, compound microscopy and molecular microscopy. So the advanced method to determining the size of nanoparticle, which is atomic force microscopy. Okay, question number 32. Chimeric peptides have cyclomicrons, polymeric micelles, peptidomimetic antibodies or polymeric nanoparticles. So the correct answer, chimeric peptides have peptidomimetic antibodies. Okay, question number 33. Use of monoclonal antibodies for drug delivery tumor is active targeting, passive targeting, triggered drug targeting or vector targeting. So the correct answer is, for use of monoclonal antibodies for drug delivery to tumor is, which is, it is a active targeting. So now this is the second last question of this video. Is an example of a synthetic biodegradable polymer, which options are acrolein, polyethylene glycol, LDPE and polystyrene. So the example of synthetic biodegradable polymer, which is polyethylene glycol, also known as PEG. Okay, in an example of a biodegradable polymer, which is polyorthoesters, polycarbonate, flucarbon and polystyrene. So the example of biodegradable polymer, which is polyorthoesters. Okay, so we have discussed 35 questions of this subject. Hope you like it. And if you are preparing for GPAT, I would love to invite you on our Telegram and Instagram account. If you like to join, links are in the description box. Click and be a member of Target GPAT. Thank you, and thank you for watching this video. Bye.